Okay, the next two awesome things are related because they're both connected to a move I made to a town called Hillsboro, North Carolina. So I'd been living in Durham, North Carolina for 7 years, knew that I was looking for a change, decided to sell half of my things, put the other half in storage, and take my bed and my books and probably too many kitchen gadgets and moved in with a friend named Ellen who was living in Hillsboro and just rent a room in her house, as if that's something that people my age do all the time. It didn't fit any norms I knew. People were confused by it. I could afford a mortgage if I wanted. Why would I want to rent a bedroom in a friend's house? But I thought, you know, what if it's awesome? When I lived in Durham, I was 5 to 8 minutes away from the office. So I had basically no commute. When I moved to Hillsboro, my commute became 20 to 25 minutes. And I found myself listening to more podcasts than I usually listen to just because I had that extra time in the car. And I love to read. I love it. I am a reader, capital R, capital E, capital A, you know, etc. So I was looking for podcasts about reading and authors and books. And of course, the ones I found were all about writers whose new books had come out. So writers would come on these programs and be asked questions about the plot, the character development, how much of the story, regardless if it was deemed fiction or autobiography, was, you know, true. Their writing process and how they keep the creative spirit alive. I got so sick of these because no one was asking the questions that I wanted to ask. And that is, what are you reading? What fuels you? How does you become a writer? Because you know that the most passionate, dedicated, fucking awesome writers began as readers. They had to. There is no other way. So I wanted that story and no one was asking it. So I get home from work one day and start complaining about these podcasts. No one's asking the questions I want to ask. She says, why don't you propose a new program that asks writers about reading, like make the program you want and submit the proposal to the new community radio station in Hillsboro called WHUP 104.7. Yep, that's WHUP. So I did. I submitted a proposal for a program called The Spine, a show about the ways that reading can change how we think, love, and live. They loved it. They also wanted me to do it, which I wasn't counting on. But after a few days of asking, what if it's awesome, I couldn't come up with the reason not to do it. Because I just moved to this town, it'd be a great way to meet people. I would get to interview writers. And who knows how big it could get, right? So I start in Hillsboro and then I email people in New York, in California, in Minnesota, make it national and not local. So yeah, now I have a podcast called The Spine. It's on iTunes and Stitcher as well. Plays every week on WHUP FM 104.7. And I love it. I have so many ideas for that, far beyond a podcast. And I can't wait to see what happens because you know what? I keep asking. Say it with me. What if it's awesome? By the way, the move to Hillsboro took place in August of 2015, and the podcast started a couple months later in October.